Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
It's good to see all of you. Good to be together on this Lord's Day. It is Ascension Sunday. We remember today how Jesus was ascended to heaven. We remember today that the disciples were instructed to wait for the Holy Spirit. And I think we know the end of that story because we celebrate Pentecost every year. And that's because we remember how faithful the disciples were. And God gave his Spirit. And because God gave his Spirit to them and because they were faithful, we are able to join here today. We have heard the message of God's love. It has made its way to us. And now we are the ones to go and tell that story. We're glad to be together as we worship this morning. As you see in the announcements, the next Sunday is Pentecost Sunday. It's a day to wear red. We'll be vested in red in the paraments, and so you're invited and encouraged to wear red. We don't know if it'll be Philly's red, John or Rich, but it can be a better day to wear red for other reasons, to remember God's Spirit that was given so many years ago. We also want to take a moment to observe those and recognize those who are having birthdays this coming week. We have two who are having birthdays today. Wadia Corpoy is having a birthday today, and Kayla McManus is having a birthday. And your sister-in-law, Christine, is also today. Christine is also having a birthday today, a crowded day, May the 29th. Also note that on June the 1st, Rhonda Whited from Frankfurt Memorial is having a birthday. And on June the 4th, Jacob Bonbo Jr. from here at Crescentville is having a birthday. Are there any other birthdays this coming week? Wendy? Tina is June the 1st. We wish Tina a happy birthday today. On the 1st. Sue? Mark is June the 3rd. We wish a happy birthday to Mark. Yes. Coco? Your father turned 83 last Thursday. Well, let's celebrate that today. Janelle's birthday is the 5th. Well, happy birthday to Janelle this week. Happy birthday to you. Any other birthdays this coming week? Well, we wish all of you and those from here in our congregation, we wish all of you a happy birthday this coming week. Are there any other announcements to be made? Sue?
Good morning. I have good news, really good news. We received a message from the DS, the district superintendent, that we received a grant for our heater project. As you know, we are faced with a whole new heater this year, which is going to be at least $25,000. So that's a big ticket, and that's why we have our donor tributes for the heater fund. And so the district has given us $5,000. We applied for a grant. It's a Metro Ministries grant. And we received $5,000, which is amazing. That's a good start for, you know, thinking we have 25 or more. And just this year, we also replaced the heater in the parsonage, which was almost 10,000, and a new heater liner. So we've had some expenses this year, but we're really pleased and excited about the fact that we received a grant. So thanks for your contributions. If you have any more, that'd be great, because we still have a bit to go. So appreciate it. And our flea market that we had, we made $1,500, which is incredible. And we're gonna try to do that again soon because we have so much stuff left. So all good things coming. Thanks.
Amen, thank you. If it helps any, we won't use the parsonage heater all summer. Are there any other announcements to be made? Then let's join together. And let's stand as we do to sing and welcome each other through our chorus of welcome. I'm so glad I'm a part of the family of God.
I'm so glad I'm a part.
This morning we ask Naima to come forward. She's going to be leading the beginning parts of our service. We thank her for her willingness to represent the youth today, and we are glad, Naima, that you're with us. Thank you.
Please join me in the call to worship. Jesus prayed, I pray not only for them, but also for those who believe in me, because of their message. I pray that they may all be one. Father, may they be in us, just as you are in me and I am in you. May they be one, so that the world will believe that you sent me. I gave them the same glory you gave me, so that they may be one, just as you and I are one. I in them and you in me, so that they may be completely one, in order that the world may know that you sent me, and that you love them as you love me.
Let us join in singing together our opening hymn, Hail the Day That Sees Him Rise.
Hail the day that sees him rise, Alleluia, to his throne beyond the skies, Alleluia. Christ the Lamb for sinners killed, Alleluia, enters now the highest heaven, Alleluia. Highest heaven its Lord receives, Alleluia. Yet he loves the earth he leaves, Alleluia. Though returning to his throne, Alleluia, still he calls the world his own, Alleluia. See, he lifts his hands above, Alleluia. See, he shows the wounds of love, Alleluia. Hark, his gracious lips bestow, Alleluia. Blessings on his church below, Alleluia.
Please join me in the opening prayer. God of power and wisdom and might, who always seeks our good, hear us that, as we know our Savior is seated with you in majesty, so may we also know that he abides with us to the end of the world. Through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord, we pray. Amen.
I want to show you something. I'm sorry? I'm missing that, Michael. I'm sorry. A ticket to paradise. You know, it might be. This was on the desk in the office a couple of Sundays ago. Might have been last Sunday. It's from Riona. And it says, I love everybody. I wanted to show this and tell you about it because show and tell is the title of the sermon today. And if I say those two words, show and tell, what comes to mind by some of you older kids, maybe? Huh? What do those words mean? School. All of a sudden, you're back in school. Was it a good thing, a good memory? Huh? Gene, what did you show and tell in school? Yes. Yes. And that's an interesting response, because I think that's how I was remembering. When I thought back of show and tell, I thought, what did I bring in? I don't remember. But it was an interesting time, and it was a little nervy because you had to stand up in front of all your classmates and tell them about something that you brought from home. Do you guys, Janelle or Riona, do you do show and tell in your school? Yes? What are some things you take with you to tell about in school? You remember? Real loud. Your doll? Oh, your drawings. You make drawings and then you tell about them in school. That's wonderful. That's wonderful. Anybody else? Yes? You took your cousin. Wow. How about that? How about that? A live show and tell item. Wow. Michael. Well, those two words came to mind a few weeks ago when I began looking at this passage of scripture from Luke's gospel, the idea of show and tell. And that nervousness that Jean's talked about. I called Karen Shallcross this week. She's a member who's not able to get out too often at Frankfurt Memorial. But the reason I called Karen Shallcross is because Karen Shallcross went to college in Millersville, just outside of Lancaster, and did her student teaching at Burroughs Elementary, where I went. So she taught with Mrs. Gemmel, who was my second grade school teacher, a few years after I had been in second grade. So it's always neat to talk to Karen about Burroughs School, because it makes me feel like I'm a kid again. But what I found interesting she talked about the nervousness of students, but she talked about how when they brought something from home that they really liked, it gave them a confidence. It gave them a little bit of excitement to want to show and tell their classmates about whatever that toy, it was often a toy, she said, but whatever those toys were, whatever that item was, cousins even, we can feel good about, and that can calm our nerves enough to be able to tell our classmates and tell our friends. So I'm hoping that we can be thinking about this idea of show and tell. Don't think back too far that you're not here with us this morning, but in the message or in the lesson that we hear from Luke's gospel today, be thinking about show and tell and how Jesus might have been showing and telling his disciples as he was preparing to leave the earth. As we go to prayer this morning, we have much for which to pray. And I would ask if you have concerns today to share, or if you have joys to share, that you might share them in a way that we would be able to pray together, pray for each other, as well as rejoice in knowing God's faithfulness with one another. Michael, well, we pray for Thanksgiving that you are becoming more and more aware of that. And we pray for you to continue to be able to be healthy enough to come to service and to bless others with your presence. Well, we're glad that you're with us today, Michael. Thank you. Let's pray for Michael. He continues to be strengthened through these days. Other joys or other concerns today? Sue? Okay. Prayers for Tony. Let's pray for Tony this day. Eva? Okay. Prayers for Hank. Hank recently had a heart catheterization and there's some fluid in around his heart, I believe. Is that what you told me, Eva? So let's be in prayer for Hank as he's experiencing some discomfort. Let's pray for him to be strengthened and healed in these days. Yes, Allison, I'm sorry. Okay, traveling mercies for your family and prayers for your sister-in-law. Anna? Alex? I'm sorry. Annex. Okay, let's pray for Annex as well today. Farrell, let us be in prayer for Farrell as she begins this new position in the preschool, that it is a school, and we want to pray for her as well as the children that she will be working with and her co-workers. Let us be in prayer for Farrell in this way. Yeah, let's pray for Wes this morning, who has injuries, and we want to pray for him to be strengthened and healed. Naima. Prayers of travel safety for Muhammad, who is traveling back from Sierra Leone. Let us be in prayer for Muhammad. Is that today? Next week? It'll be next week. Let us be in prayer for him. Jean. Prayers for Haiti. Yes. Yes. Jean told me that today is Mother's Day in Haiti. So let us pray for the mothers of Haiti today, but let us also pray for the nation of Haiti this morning. Coco. Prayers of thanks that Philip made the prom. Yes. Wonderful. Wonderful. Michael's been working at quitting smoking, and he's free for 3 days. We encourage you to keep at it, and we will pray for you to have strength. Yes, yes. We certainly want, for Suzanne this morning. Yes. Jean. Yes. Let's pray today for the Burke family who have experienced death. John. Yes. Yes. We pray for the people of Uvalde, Texas, as well as the people in Buffalo, New York. And we pray for our own citizenry here in Philadelphia as we experience violence each and every day. Let us continue to pray that God would intervene in a way that we would know it is God. We are struggling, as you know, and we simply need to continue to pray for the people who have suffered, but also pray for each other and pray for ourselves as to how we might respond to all of this violence that we see so much around us. I would also ask for prayers for Ed Engel. We asked prayers for him last Sunday. He had a fall. I spoke with his wife, Chris, this week. He had a fall. And he's in pretty bad shape to where he's going to be needing a lot of therapy and a lot of rehabilitation going forward. So I would just continue to ask for prayer for Ed and for Chris and for their family as they continue this new road of challenge. If you have raised a concern or a joy, if you would please take a moment to write it down in the prayer card that should be in the pew in front of you, and place those in the offering plate. That way, again, we can put these in our bulletin so that we have these to be able to pray for each other. Let us, as we continue to look to prayer, I'm going to offer a prayer as it is Memorial Day tomorrow. And so I would ask that we begin with a time of silent prayer and then that we then continue to pray together. Let us be in prayer. Gracious and loving God, who is Lord of all nations, on this Memorial Day weekend, we pause to reflect upon our blessings as a nation, and the high cost of those blessings for many. We thank you for the freedom we enjoy in this country, for opportunities to better ourselves, and for the security in our land. We thank you for those who have served in the armed forces of our nation, risking their lives for our liberty. We thank you for those who have given their lives in sacrifice to our country, sacrificing in such a costly way for the sake of others, including us gathered here. We thank you for a day set apart, not just for celebration, but also for solemn remembrance as we ponder the sacrifices of so many in our military. And as we do so, we pray that we would be more aware of how blessed we are as a nation. Help us to see in new ways so that we can be more grateful for our blessings, more faithful in our expressions of thanks, and more eager to share the life that you have given us with others. As we pray for the families and friends of those who have given their lives in service to our nation, we ask that they may be comforted in their sadness. May they be reassured that the sacrifice of their loved ones contributes to a worthy cause. May they honor those they have lost, entrusting their lives into your loving arms. Guide those who lead our nation in international affairs. Help them to pursue diplomatic paths that prevent needless conflict. May they have your wisdom about when and how to use the military might that is ours. As you are a God of peace, we pray that you would stir in the hearts of the leaders of all nations and in all who would use violence to further their cause. Change their hearts and their minds, O God. Give them a passion for peace. Bring an end to the pain, we pray, the suffering, the injustice and violence in our world. Even as we pray, we know that ultimate peace will not come until your kingdom is here in all of its fullness. Nevertheless, we pray for a foretaste of the future, and we commit anew to strive to live in peace with those around us. We ask for the growth of peace throughout our world today, so that fewer and fewer men and women will have to risk and even to sacrifice their lives. We long for the day when all of us will beat our swords into plowshares, our spears into pruning hooks. When nation shall not lift up sword against nation, when neither shall they learn war anymore. May your kingdom come, O Lord, and your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. This all we pray in the name of Jesus, who is the Prince of Peace. We even pray as he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses and debts, as we forgive our debtors and those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Let us continue now in our worship as we receive our morning tithes and gifts and offerings.
When you give to the least in the kingdom, when you give as unto the Lord, oh, you'll never lose by giving, for giving brings its own reward. When you give, it makes you feel happy. When you give, it makes you feel good to share what the Lord has given to you with the rest of your brothers.
And sing with thankful hearts, praise God, from whom all blessings flow.
Praise God, from whom all blessings flow. Praise God.
Oh God, we give you thanks for all the ways that you provide for us. We give you thanks for the many ways that we know of your goodness. And out of our thankfulness, we give you these gifts and pray that you would bless them. Bless those who have given and those who will receive, we ask, as we pray this now in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Let us continue in song by singing together, "Break Thou the Bread of Life." Be seated. Together, let us hear the lesson from the gospel for the day, from the gospel according to St. Luke, chapter 24, verses 44 through 52. Jesus said to them, "These are my words that I spoke to you while I was still with you, that everything written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets and the Psalms must be fulfilled." Then he opened their minds to understand the scriptures. He said to them, "This is what is written. The Christ will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and a change of heart and life for the forgiveness of sins must be preached in his name to all nations, beginning from Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. Look, I'm sending to you what my father promised, but you are to stay in the city until you have been furnished with heavenly power." He led them out as far as Bethany, where he lifted his hands and blessed them. As he blessed them, he left them and was taken up to heaven. They worshiped him and returned to Jerusalem overwhelmed with joy. This is the word of our Lord. Thanks be to God. He led them out as far as Bethany, where he lifted his hands and blessed them. As he blessed them, he left them and was taken up to heaven. They worshiped him and returned to Jerusalem with great joy. I know that I had written, because Sue requires me to turn these bulletins in so early, wink, wink, hint, hint. I had written the title "Show and Tell," but if I were to rename this sermon, I might say, "They what?" To this last line, this last verse of this lesson. They returned to Jerusalem overwhelmed with joy after Jesus had left them. You know, we talk about people, or we hear people often say, "I've been taken out of context." It is a quote to say from John or from Luke's gospel, "As he blessed them, he left them." If we stop there, that sounds pretty sad. Pretty hard. Yet we have the words that precede those words, and we have the witness and the joy and the celebration of those disciples that followed. so that when Jesus left them, somehow was reason to rejoice. It's interesting to note these verses that we read this morning are the 44th through the 52nd verses of the 24th chapter of Luke. 52 verses is a pretty big chapter. We go back into the beginning of that chapter, it's when we read about the resurrection of Jesus. It's also within the chapter, this 24th chapter of Luke, where Jesus comes to meet up with those followers of his on their way to, and it just escaped me. No, they weren't going to Jerusalem. Oh, I'll get it. They were on their way. And Jesus walked with them. And if Emmaus, thank you. They were on their way to Emmaus. And Jesus walked with them. And it was only after he left them that they realized they had been in the presence of the Christ. It was in this same chapter where Jesus now is speaking these words to his disciples, telling them everything of why he came to the earth. A recap, if you will, of his purposes in coming to the earth. That God had been a part of the earth long before he even showed up. He opened their minds, Luke tells us, understand the scriptures. Somehow he reminded them that in the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Somehow he reminded them of Noah and Moses, of David, Isaiah and Jeremiah and all of the prophets, those who have stood before his coming to proclaim that God was here. God had given life to everyone on earth. And somehow, as a professor in our seminary put it one day in a lecture, he talked about how God decided to put on arms and legs and come down. That's how we came to know God in this man named Jesus. And this Jesus now is opening the minds and the hearts of those disciples so that they will more fully understand why he had come. He spoke to them of the importance of the need for him to die, to be raised from the dead, and for our need to proclaim his death, to proclaim his resurrection. Because through that, we come to receive the forgiveness of God. Jesus was for us the sacrificial lamb. Jesus wanted to make sure his disciples understood all of that. And so he says to them, you are witnesses of these things. You have been with me for these 3 years. You know better than anyone this message of God. So now as I am getting ready to leave you, I won't leave you without help. Stay in the city, he tells them. Stay together. And God will do as God has promised. You will receive the Spirit of God. Everything is okay up until this point. But when Jesus leads them to Bethany and he begins to be ascended to God, leaving these disciples, they are able somehow to understand. They are able to somehow believe that all that he said was going to come true. And they could rejoice in that moment because they knew there was more that God had for them. So after he left them, after he blessed them one last time, they worshiped him. They returned to Jerusalem with great joy. They knew there were better things even to come. And they believed that. They followed the words of Jesus. Because they waited another 10 days on that first Pentecost Sunday that the Spirit was given, they were together to receive that Spirit, to be formed into what we now know as the church. Because of their faithfulness, because they believed, because they showed and they told this story, we can sit here today. We can rejoice. We can give thanks because we can be assured of this same presence. We know by faith that the Spirit of God that was received on Pentecost is now within us. We become, in effect, the holders of that Spirit. We become the ones who can show and tell love, mercy, the goodness of God. So it may not be a toy anymore that you might nervously want to talk about to someone. There may be a love and a kindness and a goodness and gentleness that you can show in your life to others. Because God's Spirit is here. We are God's people. We are the church that God has built. So it is our opportunity now to be the holders of this Spirit and to be the ones who give it away, knowing that God will always give us everything we need. As the disciples were witnesses of these things, you now are the witnesses of these things. And our challenge as we place ourselves in this story, will we believe as they did? Will we rejoice as they did? Will we go and show and tell? Amen. Desiring to go and show and tell, affirming our faith is a way that we indicate that. So I invite you to stand together. Let us join in this affirmation of our faith, these words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, the life everlasting. Amen. Now let us sing together thankfully. Jesus shall reign.
Jesus shall reign wherever the sun does its successive journeys run. His kingdom stretch from shore to shore, till moon shall wax and wane no more. To him shall endless prayer be made, and praises throng to crown his head. His name like sweet perfume shall rise, with every morning sacrifice. People and realms of every tongue dwell on his love with sweetest song, and infant voices shall proclaim their early blessings on his name. Blessings abound where'er he reigns. prisoners leap to loose their chains. The weary find eternal rest, and all who suffer want are blessed.
Go now in peace, as holders of God's Spirit, to show and tell the wonders of God's love. Go now in peace to make that love known in all that you do and to all that you are with. And know this day that the blessing of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, goes with you now and will remain with you forevermore. Amen.
I love to tell the story, 'tis pleasant to repeat. What seems each time I tell it more wonderfully sweet. I love to tell the story, for some have never heard the message of salvation from God's own holy word.
God bless you all. Go in peace.